Hey guys, Alex here. Been a while since I made a video because I'm busy working. So what I want to talk today to you today about is the 2018 Mustang and what to expect when it comes to real world expectations. So a lot of people out there are seeing that the 2018 Mustang is already a stout platform that's going real fast right away. But when you look closer, you gotta understand a lot of the cool things that make the 2018 Mustang different than the 2015 to 17 are being absolutely negated, taken away from the equation. Case in point, when you put a return style fuel system in a 2018 and you rely on the injector, you're basically using a high compression Coyote and negating the direct injection. Basically, you're saying direct injection off, blending to zero, and you're letting the injectors do all the work. Nothing wrong with that if you just wanna make power, that's fine. But you gotta understand, 90%, I am saying 90%, to this day, I still have guys with 15 to 17 blowers that will never go E85. They'll absolutely never go E85. All they'll do is stick with pump gas. They're not looking to break records. They're looking to just be quicker than a ZL1, be quicker than a ZL6, but stay on pump gas so they can drive around the country and not have to freak out, download an app on their phone to find where the nearest E85 station is. Others don't want to spend $1,800 to $1,900 on a return style fuel system if they don't have to. A lot of guys that buy Roush RS3s, they buy them because it's a factory built blown car, and if they get a phase 2 calibration with a booster and a smaller pulley, it can be pretty damn stout. So the key is going to be, how much power can you make on pump gas? Now, I really hate relying on pump gas, but this direct injection changes things. The 2018 Mustang, with their direct injection, you can change the blending. You can go 100% direct injection pump, direct injection. You can go 100% port injection, or you can blend 50-50, 60-40, 70-30, whatever you wanna do. 9 times out of 10, you're gonna run out of pump with direct injection. They happened with the EcoBoost platform, the 2.3. So what were people doing? People were installing auxiliary fuel systems, basically port style injection to the side of the manifold, and using like a MS3 or a mini squirt software to basically control those auxiliary injectors, or meth. People were just shoving meth down its throat for auxiliary fueling and octane. But this 2018 Mustang has to be different. It has to be different because people aren't gonna jerry-rig port injection this and that. People are not gonna put meth on these cars. People are not gonna wanna do all that bullshit. 90% of our customers want to get in the car, push the button, drive it, go to Shell, BP, Chevron, or Texaco, or whatever it is, and just have 680 plus rear wheel horsepower on tap. They don't wanna play that game. Now, the problem nowadays with shops and other people is what they do is they go for the record first, as opposed to getting data. And that's fine. If they wanna go for record, cool. The first to do this, the first to do that. But at the end of the day, you're gonna have to tune what the customers bring to you. And 90% of the time, the customers dictate what your volume-driven tuning is. So what is the biggest volume of customers? What kind of gas are they using on supercharged applications and even naturally aspirated applications? They're using pump gas. Pump gas with an additive, 94. Sometimes they use 260GT, which is basically 100 octane, you know, unleaded 100 octane. So that's gonna be the key. We're not gonna do the Chevy thing where we shove meth down his throat. I raced a Cadillac CTSV the other day, a V3. I'm saying he had all the shit done to it in my red car. And of course I gapped him, but we stopped and talked. I noticed when he went wide open throttle, an insane amount of black smoke came out of the, I mean like, wow, I was just spewing out the back. I'm like, this bitch is a 2017 or 2016 brand new Cadillac. How the hell is it spewing black smoke at wide open throttle? Oh, he's like, meth. It's like, God damn it. To this day, those guys, not those guys, I really shouldn't talk badly about those guys, but the meth, the patching, it works. I get it. It makes power. But look, man, there are other ways. There's many ways of skinning a cat. And I'll be damned if my brand new Cadillac, when I go wide open throttle, looks like a Banks is a tuned 7.3 power stroke going down the street. That's not my style. That's not why I bought a car that's so expensive. So the direct injection is going to be the key factor, and the key factor is who can get you the data on pump gas first. That's going to be the biggest issue, the biggest key, because when Roush comes out with their blower, because it's going to happen, when Roush comes out with their blower, when Ford Racing comes out with their blower kit, and they slap it on 2018 Mustangs because there's hood clearance issues, this and this and that, other manufacturers are coming out with supercharger kits, that's fine. They're going to have to do the same thing. They're going to have to figure out how to make power on pump gas, because if you tell people, oh, buy a return style fuel system and go E85, they're going to look at you like you got two heads, and they're going to say you're full of shit, and they're going to find someone that can do it on pump gas. So that's going to be the next challenge on 2018 Mustang, making power on pump gas in a direct injected application. Direct injection is almost like free octane. You inject it right into the bitch, and it's basically like free octane. It's something that can be used and be insanely beneficial. But you know, if you're not gonna make hard parts, if you're not gonna do the effort to do all you can to get the most power out of pump gas, then you're literally telling 70, 80, 90% of the public out there, fuck you, buy a $2,000 fuel system and go E85 and that'll work. Now, if you were to tell me, Alex, I wanna make big power, I wanna make 800, that's when I start telling you, yes, E85, this and this and that. But on the 2018 Mustang, the challenge is gonna be, how much can we make on pump gas? And it better be a good number, because if not, people are just gonna stick to these 15 to 17 Roush vehicles that were making high sixes, low sevens with a little additive, and the car was happy as hell. So that's what's going on in the industry. Wanted to give you guys a little bit of a sneak peek into the window as to what's happening with 2018 Mustang. A lot of guys are going fast, but no one's doing it on pump gas yet, and that's the next challenge. Thanks for listening, guys. We'll talk to you later.
Trust me, this is not the place for you to bring your children.
The B-O-N-E, we got plenty of flaws. From Cleveland, Ohio, we rolling them balls. They told me this record was only for pros. So lazy gon' get MVP, I suppose. Bones, climbing them Cadillac.